Hi everyone, today we will solve some very good problems based on the topic of principle of calorimetry. But before we solve questions, let us quickly go through the important concepts and formulae in this topic. Let us consider two bodies, one of them is hot and the other one is cold. The temperature of the hot body I am assuming T1, which is greater than temperature T2 of the cold body. M1, M2 represents the masses of the two bodies and C1, C2 represents the specific heat of the two bodies. Sometimes we use the letter S for specific heat. Right now I am using C. Now, when they are brought in contact, what will happen? The hot body will lose heat to the cold body and cold body will gain heat from the hot body. Till when this exchange of heat will occur? This exchange of heat will occur till they reach thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium means till they both acquire same temperature. Now, this diagram very beautifully explains what is going to happen when you bring the two bodies in contact. The first body has temperature T1, the hot body, and the cold body has temperature T2. Right now, T1 is greater than T2. When you bring them in contact, the hot body will lose heat, its temperature will drop, and cold body will gain heat, its temperature will rise. Till when this will happen? This will happen till both of them will acquire same temperature. Once they will have same temperature, they will not exchange heat. The hot body, there will be no hot body and cold body because both of them will have same temperature, right? Now, how much heat is lost by the hot body? The formula is mass of the body, specific heat of the body into temperature difference of the hot body. Now, initially the hot body was at what temperature? T1. Finally, what is the temperature? T. So, what is the temperature difference? Bigger one minus smaller one. Always write bigger one minus smaller one because we have written here heat lost, right? If you have, let's say, 10 apples and suppose you have now 6 apples, then how many apples you lost? 10 minus 6 you will write, right? 10 minus 6, not 6 minus 10. What about cold body? Now, cold body's temperature will increase from T2 to T1, right? So, therefore, heat gained by the cold body will be mass of the cold body, specific heat of the cold body into temperature difference. And here, since temperature went from T2 to T and T is bigger than T2, so write T minus T2, right? Now, when a body gains heat or loses heat to change its temperature, the formula used is mass into specific heat into temperature difference. I have put modulus so that you write bigger temperature minus smaller temperature because heat lost or gained has to be positive number. Now, during the change of state of a substance, change of state means what? When it goes from solid to liquid or liquid to solid, or it could be liquid to gas or gas to liquid. So during this change of state, which is called melting or boiling, temperature doesn't change. Remember that. So if temperature doesn't change, delta T will be zero. So you cannot use this formula to find heat lost or gained during the change of state. So during the change of state, what formula we use? Mass into latent heat. So this L is called latent heat. Now, there are two kinds of latent heat depending on the process. So if solid is becoming liquid or liquid is becoming solid, the latent heat we use is latent heat of fusion. So this is latent heat of fusion. And when liquid becomes gas or gas becomes liquid, the latent heat that we use here is latent heat of vaporization. Latent heat of vaporization. So please try to remember, this is used when temperature changes but state doesn't change. This is used when state is changing but temperature does not change. Let us now quickly go through the units of specific heat and latent heat. So from this formula for heat lost or gained, mass into specific heat into temperature difference, specific heat will be given by this formula, right? Now, heat in SI unit is measured in joules and mass in SI unit, it is measured in kgs. So, the unit will be joules per kg per degree Celsius or Kelvin. Any one you can use. Why? Because see, if temperature is in Celsius, when you convert in Kelvin, then of course the temperature will change. The numerical value will change, right? 0 degree Celsius is not 0 Kelvin. 0 degree Celsius is 273 Kelvin. Similarly, 100 degree Celsius is 373 Kelvin. So obviously the temperature value will change from Celsius to Kelvin. But this is not temperature value. This is change in temperature. Now, if you calculate change from 0 to 100, what is the change? 100. And from 273 to 373, what is the change? 100, right? So the change will be same whether you use in Celsius scale or you use in Kelvin scale. So any one you can use. Similarly, for latent heat, the unit will be joules per kg. So though we have written the unit in joules per kg per Celsius, I will sometimes use calories and gram. Why? Because it makes the problem easier, especially for water. And try to remember, one calorie is nothing but 4.2 joules. Okay. Now, in a given problem, the specific heat of a body will be usually given. However, it is quite important if you can remember the specific heat of water, in the units of calories per gram per degree Celsius. So the value of specific heat of water is 1 calories per gram per degree Celsius. If you want to write in terms of kilocalories per kg, then also it will be 1, because kilocalories will have 1000 calories and kg will have 1000 gram. So 1000 can be cancelled, you will get same answer. Right? Try to remember the specific heat of ice or steam is 0.5 or half in the same units. Okay. Now, if you want to convert the final answer in, let us say, SI units, joules, then we have to use this formula to convert calories into joules. One calorie is approximately 4.2 joules. So just like specific heat of water and ice or steam, you should try to remember. Try to also remember the latent heat of fusion when ice is converted to water or water is converted to ice. So the value in calories per gram is very easy to remember, 80 calories per gram. Similarly, from water to steam or steam to water, the latent heat of vaporization is 540 calories per gram. Let us see the first question. 100 grams of water, which is at 80 degrees Celsius, is mixed with 50 grams of water at 40 degrees Celsius. So this water is hot and this water is cold. They are asking you to find the final temperature of the mixture. Now I am trying to show the problem in the form of a picture. So the cold water has mass 50 gram at 40 degree and hot water has mass 100 grams at 80 degree, right? Now you know what is going to happen. When you bring them in contact, the hot water will lose heat and its temperature will drop from 80 degree to some final value which we have to calculate. Similarly, the water's temperature, which was 40 degree, the cold water, it will gain heat and its temperature will rise. Remember, the final temperature cannot be more than 80 and it cannot be less than 40. So the final temperature should be somewhere in the middle of 80 and 40. So how to calculate this? Well, we know the formula. This is the formula for heat lost or heat gained when temperature changes, remember. And in this problem, only temperature is going to change. Water is not going to become ice, or ice is not going to become water. So what is the heat lost from here to here? Let us calculate that heat lost. So mass of the water, 100 grams into specific heat. Now in the units of calories, if I write, what was the specific heat? 1, right? 1 calorie per gram per degree Celsius. And change in temperature from here to here, in modulus if I write, the bigger temperature I should write first. So 80 minus T. So this is the heat lost, right? Mass, specific heat, change in temperature, but bigger temperature should be written first. Similarly, this will be your heat gained. Right, so heat gain will be how much? Mass of water is 50, right? Specific heat of water, since both are water, specific heat will be same. And change in temperature from 40 to T. T is bigger than 40, so how I should write? T minus 40, right? So this is heat
lost by the hot water and this is heat gained. Now, according to the principle of calorimetry, if no other losses or gain of heat is there, if only these two bodies interact, then heat lost by one body must be equal to heat gained by the other body. So this number, which is heat lost, should equal this number, which is heat gained. 50 into 1 is 50, T minus 40. Now 50 and 100 can be cancelled, right? 52 is 100. So 2 into 80 will be 160 minus 2T, T minus 40. So if you take minus 2T this side and minus 40 this side, you will get 200 equals to 3T, isn't it? And therefore your T will be 200 divided by 3. So this will give you 3 6 are 18, 2 carry, 3 6 are 18, again 2 carry, so 6.66 degree Celsius would be the final temperature. Now try to understand this concept. I have considered two bodies, cold and hot. Cold body's temperature is T1, hot body is T2. When they are mixed, you know that the cold body will gain heat. And what will be the gain in heat? Mass into specific heat into difference in temperature. So T is the bigger temperature, T minus T1. Similarly, the hot body will lose heat, so its temperature will drop from T2 to T. So mass into specific heat into bigger temperature minus smaller temperature. Now, if this product of one body is greater than this product, as I have mentioned here, so if this product is greater than this product, then obviously this one will be less than this one, isn't it? This will be less than this. Why? Because take any example, numerical value, let's say 2, I want this to be more, right? So let's say 8 into 2 is equals to 4 into 4. 16 is equal to 16. Now look here, this 8 is greater than 4, isn't it? So this is, I'm assuming, greater than this. Then this should be less than this, right? So this, whatever number is this, it should be less than this number. Now if this number should be less, then it means what? T should be closer to T1 than compared to T2, correct? No, if this number is very close to this number, the difference will be small, isn't it? So try to remember, if the product of mass into specific heat is more, the final temperature will be nearer to that body whose temperature is T1. Understood? So try to remember this. The body which has more mass into specific heat, so final temperature will be closer to the temperature of that body. So in the previous question, the 80 degree water was having how much mass? 100 gram. And the 40 degree water was having how much mass? 50 gram. So mass into specific heat of 80 degree water was 100 into 1, right? This was the mass into specific heat of 80 degree water, isn't it? Similarly, for 40 degree water, what was the mass into specific heat? Mass was 50 gram, specific heat was 1, because both were water. So who is more? This is 80 degree body has more mass into specific heat. So whichever body has more mass into specific heat, final temperature will be nearer to the temperature of that body, right? So that's why the final temperature came closer to 80 degree in the previous example, right? Let us now do a very interesting question. 10 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius is mixed with 1 gram of water at 50 degree. So now we have to find the final temperature of the mixture when thermal equilibrium will reach. And thermal equilibrium means what? Both the bodies will have same temperature, right? So I have shown the question in the form of a picture. So here we have the cold body which is ice at 0 degree and hot body which is water at 50 degree Celsius. Now, when these two systems will mix, what will happen finally? Well, that depends on the specific heat and mass and the initial temperature. But there are two possibilities. Let me explain the two possibilities. Imagine this is the ice at 0 degree, right? And this is the water at 50 degree. Now when you mix them, what will happen? Water will start losing heat, so its temperature will start coming down. Now ice will gain heat, but will its temperature go up? No, right? Because this ice has to melt. And during melting, what did we discuss? During melting or boiling, temperature doesn't change. So when you bring these two in contact, this hot water, which is at 50 degree, will give heat to this ice. Now this ice will not immediately melt, right? It will take time. So this ice will take heat from the hot water and then it will start melting. But during that time, temperature will not go up. Now, if your water is having, let's say, less mass, like I have given here, it's less mass only compared to ice. So what may happen is the water's temperature is decreasing, right? And it is hoping that this ice will go up. But this ice is saying, no, I cannot increase my temperature. First, you give me enough heat to melt. So if you don't give me enough heat to melt, my temperature cannot go up. So what is happening? It is coming down, it is coming down, but this is not going up. Why this is not going up? Because whole ice has not melted. So there is a possibility that the water's temperature has reached till 0 degree and still the whole ice has not melted, right? So there is a possibility that the whole water has dropped its temperature to 0 degree, but still the whole ice has not melted. Then what will happen? Then your final state will have a mixture of water and ice, but with some amount of ice which will melt. Remember students, after this water's temperature will reach 0 degree, then melting will stop because the temperature will become same. And once temperature becomes same, this water which is at now 0 degree will not give heat to this ice which is at 0 degree. So at 0 degree, 0 degree, heat will not flow, right? Heat only flows when there is temperature difference, right? So please remember, there is a possibility that this whole water's temperature has reached till here, till 0 degree, and this ice has not started to go up only. Why? Because maybe we have taken too much ice. So there is a chance of that. So there is a chance that the final temperature will be 0 degree. But there is also a chance where as the water's temperature comes down somewhere here, maybe when the water's temperature reaches somewhere here, there is a chance that the whole ice will melt if you take less amount of ice. So if the whole ice will melt, then what will happen? Then its temperature will start going up and then the final temperature will be somewhere here, right? So there are two possibilities in this question. The first possibility is the final temperature is 0 degree with mixture of water and ice. And the second possibility is there is only water with temperature maybe between 0 degree and 50 degree, maybe 1 degree or 30 degree or 20 degree, any number it can be, but it has to be between 0 degree and 50 degree. So I hope all of you are clear that there are two possibilities here. Now, how to find the final temperature directly? You assume that the final state is water, okay, at final temperature is T. So assume that after this ice and water has mixed, the final temperature is some T degree above 0 degree. And if it is above 0 degree, it means what? I have assumed whole ice will melt. That is my assumption. Now my assumption can be wrong or right. We will come to know after we solve. So what I have assumed? I have assumed that this water's temperature has dropped up to T degree and this ice has increase its temperature up to T degree. But remember, ice temperature will only increase after the whole ice melts. During melting, temperature doesn't change. So first the ice has to melt, then its temperature will increase. So in order for the temperature of the water to come from 50 degree to T degree, it has to lose heat. So let us calculate the heat lost. So which formula I should use? Obviously the first one, because temperature is changing here, remember, not state. So what is the formula? Mass of the body, which is 1 grams. Specific heat of water is how much in calories units? 1 calorie per gram per degree Celsius, right? So C is 1, mass is 1, and change in temperature from 50 to T will be 50 minus T. So this much heat is lost, which is simply 50 minus T. Now let us calculate how much heat is required for this ice to go from 0 degree Celsius ice to water at T degree Celsius. Now, for ice to go from 0 degree Celsius to water at T degree Celsius, what must happen? First, the whole ice should melt. So let us calculate that. So heat gained by this ice, remember. So first, before rising the temperature, first what will happen? The whole ice will melt. So what is the formula for heat required for melting? This is the formula, right? Latent heat we have to use. So mass of the ice is given 10 grams. Now latent heat of fusion, if you check the value, I told you it is 80 calories. 80 calories per gram. So this will plus, right? 80 calories per gram. So this formula is the second one, right? This one. Okay, so this is for melting. Then what should happen? Then after the whole ice has melted, whatever mass of that water is there, which came from the ice, remember, that water has to now go up. Its temperature should increase. So it should take heat. So how much heat it will take to change temperature? To change temperature, this is the formula we have to use, remember. So what is the mass of the water which came from the ice? 10 gram only, right? If you have 10 gram of ice during melting, you will get 10 gram of water. You are not allowed to eat the ice, remember. So that 10 gram of ice will give you 10 gram of water, whose temperature has to now increase. So mass into specific heat of water, 1, and change in temperature. It went from 0 degree to T. So change will be T minus 0, isn't it? So this will give you 800 plus 10 into T, right? So this is the heat lost by 50 degree water to come up to T degree, and this is the heat gained, which has two parts. What is the first part? For melting the ice. Then the remaining is to increase its temperature from 0 degree to T degree, right? And what values we have used? For specific heat, we have used 1 in the units of calories per gram per degree Celsius. And for latent heat of fusion, we have used 80 calories per gram. So now, according to principle of calorimetry, these two should be equal, isn't it? So let us say they are equal. So 50 minus T should equal 800 plus 10T. So then minus T will go that side. It will be 11T. And then 800 will come this side. So it will be minus 750, which means your final temperature is coming minus 750 by 11. Now no need to calculate this, because this is not possible. Why it is not possible? Because the temperature is coming negative. The moment the ice will gain heat, it will start melting. And therefore its temperature will be either 0 or more than 0 if the whole ice melts. But the answer is coming negative. So what does it mean? It means that the whole ice did not melt. And since the whole ice did not melt, the final temperature is how much? So therefore, final temperature is directly 0 degree Celsius. So this is how you should solve the problem if they ask you what is the final temperature, right? So in the previous question, how much ice and water are present in the final system? So as you know, some ice has melted, right? So we want to calculate how much ice is there and how much water is there. Finally, after the whole system comes in thermal equilibrium. And we found that the final temperature will be 0 degree Celsius only, because the whole ice did not melt, right? So what we came to know from the previous problem is when these two systems are mixed, the final temperature is 0 degree, right? So the final temperature is 0 degree. That means this whole water of 1 gram has to decrease its temperature up to 0 degree, right? By losing heat. So let us calculate how much heat it has to lose in order to come up to 0 degree. So heat lost will be mass of the water 1 gram. Specific heat of water is 1 calories per gram per degree Celsius. And change in temperature from 50 to 0 is 50 minus 0. So this will be 50 calories, isn't it? Now once you found the heat lost, now what about heat? Whatever that heat is lost, who will gain? Ice will gain. Now, will its temperature increase? No, because final temperature is 0 degree only, right? That means whatever heat has come from the water, that has to do something. What it will do? It will melt some amount of ice. So let us assume, let M be the ice which melts. Okay, not the entire ice, but some amount will melt. So let us assume the mass is M. So from here to here only, remember it did not increase. So from 0 degree to 0 degree only, it will gain heat during melting. Remember, as I told you, during melting, temperature will not change. So heat gained will go only in melting the ice, which will be M into latent heat of fusion. And latent heat of fusion is 80 calories, isn't it? So this is in grams, okay? So this is 80 calories per gram. So now these two should be equal. So M into 80, heat gained, should be equal to heat lost. So M will be 5/8 grams. Remember, the answer will come in grams because we have used what units? Calories per gram per degree Celsius, right? So if this much ice melts, then how much ice will be present finally? So finally, if I mention here the answer, the ice present will be, how much was present before? 10 was present, 10 gram was present. This much was present before, right? How much melted? 5/8 gram melted. So it will be 10 gram minus 5/8 gram. That if you take LCM will be 8, then 80 minus 5 will be 75 grams. And what about the amount of water? Well, 1 gram of water was already there, right? And how much water came from this melting? 5/8 grams of water came from the melting of ice. Remember, M is the amount of ice which melts. So the amount of water present will be 1 gram was originally present plus how much came from melting? 5/8. So this will be LCM will be 8 plus 5 13/8 grams, right? So this is the amount of ice present finally, and this is the amount of water present finally, and the final mixture has temperature 0 degree. Remember that. Try the same question by taking the initial temperature of water 80 degree and take the water as 100 grams. Now I feel like the whole ice will melt and then the final temperature will be somewhere here because I have given enough temperature and enough mass. Okay, so give a try to that and you can mention the answer in the comment section. Let's see the next question now. It says 5 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius is mixed with 1 gram of steam at 100 degree Celsius. Which of the following statements is correct? First option says final mixture contains water and ice at 40 degree. That is not possible. If it is water and ice, then the final temperature should be 0 degree only, right? If they say ice. Then they said final mixture contains water at 40 degree Celsius. That is possible. 40 degrees between 0 degree and 100 degree, right? Then final mixture contains ice, water and steam at 40 degree. That is also not possible. Final mixture contains water and steam at 40 degree. That is also not possible because if they say steam, it should be 100 degree and not 40 degree. So this question, without solving, we know the answer is option B. The final mixture contains water at 40 degree Celsius. But let us try to show numerically why the answer is 40 degree Celsius, right? According to the problem, we have 5 gram of ice at 0 degree and 1 gram of steam at 100 degree, right? Now, when you bring them in contact, there are three possibilities which can happen finally. Why three possibilities? Listen carefully. The moment you bring them in contact, obviously the steam will lose heat because it is hot body. So it will lose heat. And the ice, which is at cold body, it will gain heat. So the moment ice will gain heat, ice will start melting. But remember, temperature will not increase during change of state. So only melting will start, but temperature will not increase. Similarly, this steam, it will lose heat, and the moment the steam will lose heat, it will condense and become water at 100 degree only. So during that time, again, temperature will not change because during change of state, temperature doesn't change. So this will start condensing to water. This will start melting to water. Now, if you take too much of steam, then there is a chance that the whole ice may become water and that water's temperature will rise up to 100 degrees. So you will have a mixture of steam and water at 100 degrees. That will be the final state if you take too much of steam. Similarly, if you take too much of ice and little bit of steam, then there is a chance that the whole steam will condense into water and then water's temperature will drop up to 0 degrees Celsius, like the one which we did previous question. There is also a possibility where your steam condenses to water, then temperature stops decreasing and your ice completely melts and temperature starts increasing. So let us assume the third possibility and we will see if the third possibility is correct, then the answer will come any temperature between 0 degree and 100 degree. And you know now that if the temperature comes less than 0 degree, then it means the whole ice did not melt. Therefore, final temperature will be 0 degree Celsius. And similarly, if the final temperature comes more than 100 degree, then what does it mean? It means the whole steam did not condense. Therefore, the final temperature will be 100 degree Celsius, right? So here I will assume the third possibility. So I will assume there is water at temperature T. Now, for this steam to become water at T degree Celsius, it has to lose heat. So how much heat it will lose? Heat lost. Remember, first its temperature will not decrease until the complete steam has become water. Till that point, temperature will not start decreasing. So for condensing steam into water, we need latent heat of vaporization, right? So what is the formula? Mass into latent heat of vaporization. After the whole steam becomes water, now water's temperature will further decrease, right? So it will lose heat. How much heat it will lose? Mass into specific heat of water into change in temperature in modulus, right? So let us calculate this. Mass of the steam here is 1 gram. Latent heat of vaporization I gave you, right? 540 it was. Please check the value. Okay, 540 plus this is mass of the water which came from the steam. Obviously, if 1 gram of steam, if it condenses to water, you will get 1 gram of water. And what is the specific heat of water? 1 in what units? Calories per gram per degree Celsius. And change in temperature from 100 to T. 100 is the bigger temperature, so 100 minus T. So this is 540 plus 100 minus T. Right? So this will give you 640 minus T. So this is the heat lost by the steam to become water at T degree. Similarly, this ice has to gain heat. So what is the heat gained? First, remember, the whole ice has to melt. So mass into latent heat of fusion. What is the mass? Directly I will do, okay? Mass is 5 gram. Latent heat of fusion was 80 calories per gram. After the whole ice melts, the water which comes from there, that will also have mass 5 gram only into specific heat in change in temperature. From 0 to T degree will be T minus 0. So that will be 5 8s are 40, so 400 plus 5T. Now these two should be equal, right? So therefore 640 minus T should be equal to 400 plus 5T. So if you take minus T that side and 400 this side, you will get 640 minus 400 minus T will go that side 60, right? So this will give me 240 is equal to 60. So T will be 240 by 6, 6 4s are 24, so 40 degrees Celsius. And since it is between 0 degree and 100 degree, that means this will be the final temperature, right? Let us see the next question. 100 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius is mixed with 10 gram of steam at 100 degree Celsius. Final mixture contains only water at 0 degree Celsius, only ice at 0 degree Celsius, 90 gram water, 20 gram ice at 0 degree, and 90 gram ice and 20 gram water at 0 degree. So let's see which option is the correct one. So now when you mix ice at 0 degree with steam at 100 degree, the final system could be steam and water mixture at 100 degree, ice and water mixture at 0 degree, or only water at some T degree. Let me assume it is only water at T degree and see what we get. So for this system, for steam at 100 degree to become water at T degree temperature, how much heat it has to lose? So heat lost. First, the steam should condense. For that, the heat required is latent heat of vaporization. So M into L. M is 10 gram. Latent heat of vaporization is 540 calories per gram. Plus, after the whole steam has condensed, its temperature should drop. So mass into specific heat into change in temperature. Mass is 10. Specific heat of water is 1 and change in temperature is 100 minus T. 100 minus T. So this is 5400 plus 1000 minus 10 T, right? So this is 6400 minus 10 T. Okay, so this is the heat lost. What about heat gained by ice? So heat gained. Remember, directly don't use MC delta T because first the ice has to melt. So mass is 100, latent heat of fusion is 80, right? This is MLV formula, sorry, LF. This is MLV, vaporization. Then whatever water came from this melting of ice, which is 100 gram, that one into specific heat of water 1, then change in temperature is from 0 to T, T minus 0 will be T, right? So this will be 8000 plus 100 T. Now, according to our principle of calorimetry, heat lost is equal to heat gain. So 6400 minus 10 T, this is heat lost, should be equal to heat gained. 8000 plus 100 T. So from here you can see, if I take minus 10 that side, you will get 110 T, and minus this, if it comes here, what will you get? 6400 minus 8000. So from here it is very clear your T will come negative number. Since T comes negative number, the final temperature has to be 0 degrees Celsius, right? Okay. So we came to know the final temperature will be 0 degrees Celsius, right? Now, for steam to come up to 0 degrees Celsius, what should happen? It should lose heat. So how much heat it should lose? Let's redo the calculation. So mass is 10 into latent heat of vaporization was 540 plus mass is again 10 only. Specific heat is 1. Change in temperature, this time we know the final temperature is 0. So 100 minus 0 is the change in temperature. Right, guys? So please understand, this is your ML vaporization. This is MC delta T modulus. This is the heat required for converting steam into water at the same temperature 100 degree. Then this is for water at 100 degree to come up to water at 0 degree. So this will be 5400. Plus 10 into 1000 plus, oh, this is 0 degree, right? Final temperature is 0 now. And this will be 1000 only, right? So this will be 6400 calories. Since the whole ice did not melt, let us assume M ice melts. Ice which melts. So M is the mass of ice that melts. So heat required, heat gained. Who is gaining the heat? Ice. But remember, ice, it has the final temperature 0 degrees. That means the whole ice did not melt. So heat gain will be whatever mass of ice melted because of this much absorption of heat into latent heat of fusion or vaporization. Fusion. So we don't know mass. Latent heat of fusion is 80. So heat loss should be equal to heat gained, right? This is heat gained. So M into 80 should be 6400. 10 gets cancelled. This is 8 8s are 64, 80 gram. So we came to know that 80 gram of ice melts. So therefore, the final amount of ice with it, that will be present. Okay. So mass of ice present. Finally, that will be how much? 100 gram was present. How much melted? 80 gram melted. So 20 gram ice will be there. After equilibrium has reached, after both of them have reached 0 degree. See, once it reaches 0 degree, no more melting will happen, because for melting also you have to absorb heat, but absorption of heat is only possible when temperatures are different. So once the steam comes converts to water and that water comes to 0 degree, both will have same temperature, so there will be no loss or gain of heat, so melting will stop. So whatever ice was there will remain that much only, and whatever water was there, that will remain that much only. So no change will happen after equilibrium. After equilibrium. So what will be mass of water present? From here 10 gram water came, 10 gram steam when it became water, then 10 gram water came. Then from here 80 gram of water came from melting. So 90 gram of water will be finally present. So which is the right option? So 90 gram of water and 20 gram of ice at 0 degree. So option C is correct. The next question is from previous year's JE Advance. It says 2 kg of ice at minus 20 degrees Celsius is mixed with 5 kg of water at 20 degrees Celsius in an insulating vessel having negligible heat capacity. Calculate the final mass of water remaining in the container. So we have to calculate the final mass of water in the container. They have given you the specific heats of water and ice and also the latent heat of fusion. So let's see how to do it. So let us do an assumption that the final temperature is, let us assume 0 degree. Okay, instead of assuming some temperature here and then finding the temperature, because that may take more time. So what I will assume, the final temperature is 0 degree. Let us see whether this is possible or not possible. Okay. So the heat lost by the 5 kg water to come to 0 degree Celsius will be how much? Mass into specific heat into change in temperature, right? So heat lost by this water will be, mass of water is 5 kg, remember this time, into specific heat is also given per kg. So kg, kg will cancel, remember, when you substitute. So 1 kilocalorie. So the answer is, final answer will come in kilocalories. Into change in temperature from 20 to 0 will be 20 minus 0. Because we are writing heat lost. So you want this to be positive number. So bigger temperature minus smaller. So this will come 100 kilocalories. Right? So water can give this much heat. Water can lose this much heat by coming to 0 degree. Now, what about this ice? This ice, to reach 0 degree, how much heat it has to gain? So heat gained to reach 0 degree. So this will be mass of ice, specific heat of ice, Cv, right? No, into change in temperature. I am writing the formula because we are writing it for ice this time. So mass of ice is 2 kg. Specific heat of ice they have given 0.5 into change in temperature from minus 20 to 0 degree. Remember, 0 degree is more. So 0 minus minus 20. Okay, always write bigger temperature minus smaller temperature. Here the smaller temperature is minus 20. So this will be how much? This will be 2 into 0.5 is 1. And this is 20. So 20 kilocalories. When you mix these two, so when you mix these two, what will happen? This will start losing heat, this will start gaining heat, right? Now this can lose up to 100 kilocalories by reaching here. And this will need only 20 kilocalories to reach here. So that means when you first bring them in contact, when this will lose 20 kilocalories, our ice will gain 20 kilocalories from here only. So our ice will reach here. After that, what will start? Melting will start, isn't it? Now what we will do, we will check how much heat is required to melt ice. So staying here only, because the temperature of ice will go up to 0 degree. Then at 0 degree it will start melting. So heat for melting the ice, that will be equal to mass of ice is 2 kg. Latent heat of fusion is 80 kilocalories. So that will be 160 kilocalories. Kilocalories, right? That means 20 kilocalories it needs to reach up to here. Then 160 it needs more to completely melt. But this can give only 100 maximum to reach here. So that means what? That means the total ice will not melt. Because to completely melt, it needs 160 kilocalories. Plus it needs 20 to reach here. But our water can give maximum 100 kilocalories. It can lose this much only. So that means our whole ice will not melt. So let's write the whole ice will not melt. Whole ice will not melt. So now how much ice will melt? Let us assume M ice will melt. So this will be M now, right? So this we don't know now. So since we know whole ice will not melt, let me assume this much ice melts. So what is M? Ice which melts. So the total heat lost by the 5 kg water is 100 kilocalories, right? So heat lost should be equal to heat gained from the principle of calorimetry. Now what is the heat lost from here to here? 100 kilocalories. So let me write 100. Now heat gained. Remember this ice has to first reach till here. So how much it gained? It gained 20 kilocalories to reach up to 0 degree. Then melting started. So to melt this much ice, how much heat is required? M into 80 kilocalories. So plus M into 80. So from here, this 20 will come this side. 100 minus 20, 80. 80, 80 on the both sides will cancel. So M will be equal to 1 kg. Isn't it? So we came to know 1 kg of ice will melt. So how much water will be present? 5 kg was already present. So the mass of water present. Mass of water present will be equals to 5 kg was already there plus 1 kg, and therefore the answer is 6 kg, right? So let's see what happens in this situation where the mass of the ice is 2 kg at minus 20 degree and mass of water is 10 kg at 60 degree, right? So let us say this is your 0 degree Celsius. So again there are many possibilities. The final temperature can be 0, where there is ice and water. The final temperature can be in between these two number, minus 15 or minus 11, where complete ice is there, which means the whole water has frozen. Or it could be somewhere here where the final temperature is more than 0 degree Celsius but less than 60 degree Celsius. And if it is here, what does it mean? It means we have full water. Now to check which option is correct, we will start with one of the assumptions. So let me assume the final temperature is 0 degree. Okay, I am assuming that the final temperature is 0 degree, which means the whole ice did not melt. Little bit of ice is still there. So let us see what we will get now. So the amount of heat lost by this water from 60 to come to 0 will be equal to heat lost. Mass of water 10, specific heat of water 1, but in what units? Kilocalories, because this is mass is in kg, into change in temperature from 60 to 0 is 60. So 600 kilocalories, right? Okay, after that we have to calculate how much heat is required by ice to reach 0 degree. So for ice to reach 0 degree, heat gained will be mass of ice to specific heat of ice 0.1, change in temperature will be from minus 20 to 0. So 0 minus minus 20 will be 20. So this is 20 kilocalories. So you can see heat lost is 600 to reach 0 degree. So easily this water can give this much heat. So it is very clear that our ice will easily reach up to 0 degree Celsius. So the temperature won't be anything between 0 degree and minus 20 degree, right? So once we know that this option is not allowed, now we will check whether it is possible to be here or not. to calculate how much heat is required to melt the whole ice. So heat required to melt whole ice. Okay, so heat required to melt whole ice. That will be the mass of the whole ice is 2 kg and latent heat of fusion was 80 kilocalories. So this is 160 kilocalories. So you can see, students, that if water reaches up to here, it will give 600 kilocalories. But for whole ice to melt after reaching here, it needs only 160. So therefore, it is very clear that the heat given is enough. So enough heat can be given for ice to completely melt. So therefore, what we came to know, whole ice melts. Now, once I know whole ice melts, the final temperature will be somewhere here. So the final temperature is T, which we need to calculate now, because now we know whole ice will melt. So the total mass of water present will be 10 kg plus 2 kg will be 12 kg of water will be present, because 2 kg of ice will melt completely, right? Now, to reach here, how much heat should be lost by this water? Mass into specific heat into change in temperature. So 60 minus T, right? And this we will not write, because this I wrote by assuming it reaches up to 0 degree, but we know it doesn't reach up to 0 degree, because our whole ice completely melts and then its temperature will rise. Now what about heat gained? So let us now measure total heat gained by ice. So total heat gained by ice will be this much heat is used by ice to reach up to here, isn't it? After reaching there, it has to melt completely. To melt completely, we have already calculated it needs 160 kilocalories. After it has melted completely, the water which has come from the ice, that water's temperature has to go up to T degree, right? So this temperature, this heat from here to here, to increase the temperature, you have to gain heat. So how much heat that water has to gain? Mass of water is 2 kg, because from this ice only the water has come. Specific heat of water you have to use, because now that ice has become water. So 1 into rise in temperature from here to here. So T minus 0. Okay, so don't use directly from here to here, because this state is ice, that state is water, and specific heat are not same for ice and water. So this will come 20 plus 160 plus 2T, which is equal to 180 plus 2T. Then we will use principle of calorimetry. So total heat lost will be equal to total heat gained. Heat lost is 10, 60 minus T. Heat gained is 180 plus 2T. 10 into 60, 600 minus 10T equal to 180 plus 2T. So 180 will come this side. 600 minus 180 will be 420 equals to minus 10 will go that side, plus 10. So plus 10T plus 2T will be plus 12T. The final T will be 420 divided by 12. 2 6 are 12, 2 2 are 4, 2 1 are 2, 0, 2 3 are 6, 2 1 are 0, 2 1 are 2, 2 0 are 2, 5 are 3, 3 are 9, 1 carry 3, 5 are 50. So final temperature will be 35 degree Celsius. So somewhere here it will be. Okay.